Welcome to the 28th edition of Brighton Lights.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you're watching latest TV.
To an entire fashion week only in Brighton. 40 crazy designers, exclusive interviews, and we talk with the director, Liz Bishop. We get a close-up of what Jess Eaton has made out of Roadkill. Brighton Fashion Week is presented by Jenny Davidson and filmed by William Ranieri. Now let's be fashionable.
Jenny Davidson, and I'm here at Brighton Fashion Week. Now, this is only the second time that Brighton has had its own Fashion Week. It's all very exciting.
It's getting close, closer to me. I see the light.
Brighton Fashion Week launch party was just the first in a whole week of events showcasing the best of fashion from Brighton. The second night was a benefit gig in aid of the charity War Child, featuring a whole variety of musicians, including Brighton-based band The Agitator. Brighton rocks. We know that Brighton shocks. Let's see some Brighton frocks. There was a real buzz in the changing room as the models got ready for a show that featured everything from Marie Antoinette decadence to hip hop street style. I said, sugar, you'll not hold me on the false pretenses. I'm free to go anywhere.
Thank you.
Peter Jarrett, columnist, author, illustrator, man about town, gadabout.
Yeah.
Brighton Fashion Week's kind of really become big this year, yeah. Probably for the first time.
Yeah.
What do you think this is doing for the city?
I think it's doing a lot for fashion in the UK as well as Brighton. I think it's got legs and I think it's national.
It's going to walk.
I think so, it's going to walk.
Just one of the many beautiful models who's been performing here tonight. Now, Jocasta, this isn't your first time modelling, is it?
No, it's not. I've been doing Brighton Fashion Week since it was Brighton Frocks about 4 years ago.
Do you enjoy modelling?
Yeah, a lot.
What's the atmosphere like backstage at Brighton Fashion Week?
Manic. Absolutely crazy. Today was just incredibly stressful, but the outcome is just absolutely, like, fantastic. So it's all worth it at the end. Do you still think I'll be your angel?
I'm with Vanessa Austin Locke, who runs the publicity, the blog, the social media for Brighton Fashion Week. Tell me, Vanessa, what do you do?
I'm a very lucky girl. I run a team of about 10 amazing writers and photographers and some filmmakers as well. And we try and support the designers that come through Brighton Fashion Week by giving them lots of editorial, lots of promotion, lots of social media, fashion stories in Brighton and elsewhere in London and internationally as well. And we blog about them year round.
Finally, it was a night we'd all been waiting for, the Couture Catwalk Show. Come straight from your Roadkill Couture show. How are you feeling?
Good, good. I need a cold beer now. Super though.
Was the reception what you were expecting?
When you got on the stage, You don't notice if people are standing up or not. If you're so terrified with all the lights and everything, that I didn't really notice. But I'm delighted that people liked it.
You obviously got a lot of press coverage beforehand about how controversial this was going to be. Were you afraid of putting on? Were you afraid that there's going to be a negative response, protest?
I don't really care what people think. This is a piece of work that I had to do, so I'm just delighted that people like it.
It was all exceptionally stunning. Do you think it translates into a wearable look for every day? You know, is there a kind of ready-to-wear collection related to this?
Do you know, absolutely. There is definitely a market for this stuff. I know people who would wear this. I'm not talking about people, you know, everyday people on the streets, but there are definitely people. I get approached all the time about jewellery out of bones and stuff. Absolutely, I'm sure. And I will, I'm opening up a shop and I will be constantly have stock in the shop out of things that I make, that I find or eat or whatever. Yeah, absolutely.
Jess Eaton, thanks for talking to me. Absolutely stunning.
You're wonderful. Welcome, my darling. Thank you.
I asked the audience what they thought of the show.
I didn't expect it to be so elegant, but I thought it was.
Yeah, when I heard Roadkill, I was kind of thinking like Lady Gaga's meat dress for some reason. But then when it came out, it was really great. And it was a nice surprise, actually. It was lovely.
What were your favourite bits?
Roadkill. I thought he was amazing. Sounds awful, but it's a great idea. Of Jess Eaton's headpieces, like, oh my god.
Would you wear a real fur?
Well, I've got two. I didn't kill them. The people that have those sort of thoughts and that sort of creativity to create something like that is such a vision. I think it's amazing. I love it.
And do you think there's a difference in Roadkill couture from wearing, you know, fur that's been bred specially?
Yes, definitely. I mean, I prefer to wear the Roadkill. So the animals died by accident and used for fashion. It's a lot nicer when you think about it, you know.
This is Lizzy Bishop, who runs Brighton Fashion Week. Now, Lizzy, this is only the second year that it's actually been a whole week. Did you expect it to become as big as it has done?
Oh, goodness, no. Well, it just started off as a little catwalk show, and last year I said, let's just do a fashion week. And this year it is just so big. Brighton is the perfect place to host this because it's so creative. It's not something you'd see a normal catwalk started like that as Brighton Frocks. It was a bit quirky. The out of the norm designers who wouldn't normally have a chance to have a catwalk show get the opportunity. But then we're going to have the couture show. Slick catwalk. Boom.
And Brighton Fashion Week's obviously very different from, say, London Fashion Week. What's unique about Brighton? What does Brighton specially bring to fashion?
We bring a lot of designers together in one show. They all pay a little bit of money. We half sponsor them and we put on one big catwalk show. So we have 12 designers showing at once, which shares the cost, and we promote them in front of a big audience. I don't think there's anywhere really doing that in the world, really. So we differ in the way we have different models. We have really crazy designers. We're really commercial as well. We want to offer everything for all, but I want to be the international platform for creativity and innovation and up-and-coming designers in the world. That's what I want. That's my aim.
Small ambition.
No, I'm going to do it. Next 5 years. You watch.
That was absolutely stunning. We really are the most creative, the most cutting-edge city in the UK. Brighton Fashion Week. This has been Jenny Davidson reporting for latest.tv.
Latest TV, or are you?